Hey folks, it's Lindsey Hulse with SPS back in the building in a quiet room, but it was loud a little while ago. We were celebrating 2024 graduate Tyler Spratt, and the young man sitting to my left, 1990 first round draft pick. We can go on and on about his resume, but to come in here to see Tyler Spratt, who 4 years ago was at the DC Elite Summer League, and he had an interview that kind of went viral because people weren't really watching him and didn't know what was going on. And to be here now, Cleveland State, McDonald's All-American nominee, runner-up for the state championship, all these things from one of your kids, one of your pups, and you're able to come see him off. What does that mean to come see Tyler Spratt and celebrate his success?
Well, it means we're getting old.
Yeah. Why you throw me in that?
You right with me.
Right.
Well, I would say old season.
Season.
We getting season. Yeah. I mean, I've been knowing Tyler since he was in diapers. Running around, man, and to see him play on my first DC Elite.
Oh, he was part of the first
AAU team.
Wow.
Yes. You know, and to see him evolve to where he's at right now, graduating scholarship to Cleveland State, all the people, family, friends come out and support him, man. You know, it's just, it's amazing to see so many, even though the other guys that were here today. I'm sitting there watching all these kids that have played in my summer league, you know what I'm saying, in tournaments and classes and stuff that I have. And, it's just an honor, you know, for me to be a part of his celebration today.
Derrick, help me out. How difficult it is when a kid is getting all accolades as a freshman or a sophomore, and we lose so many between that time and this time. How impactful is it that he was able to stay the course and be able to be on the other side with great things happening?
Well, you already know, Lance, it comes from home training. You know, everything for me starts at home. You know, and he's raised. He got two great parents.
Yes, he does.
And but he has a support system that's been with him this whole journey of his life, whether it's me, whether it's Steve Smith, whether it's Vern, whether it's Dr. Tucker. Somebody's always giving him words of wisdom to keep him grounded, to keep him focused. And even during this whole journey in high school, I tease him all the time because I'm like, you're not aggressive enough for me. You know what I'm saying?
Still push him a little bit.
Yeah. I told him, hey, man, I ain't coming to games no more.
Wow, see, I don't like what I see.
Because you ain't being aggressive enough for me on the basketball.
So that made him do a little bit more.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Talk about that transition from high school senior to freshman year. Now, your story's a little unique, too. But talk about what that's like.
Well, it's a struggle for us always. You know, it's like going from middle school to high school. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Your ninth grade year.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So you starting over again. Nobody knows you.
Right.
You trying to figure your way around. You even know what classes you got.
All that.
You know
what I'm saying? Right.
Same thing in college. You get the opportunity to go to college, being a freshman in college. Hey, I got to find my way around campus.
Yeah.
So I got to find my classes. I got to find out the tutors. You know what I'm saying? So it's a great challenge.
It's easy to get down during that time.
It is. It really is. Especially if you go ahead of time.
Sure.
You know,
which is what Tyler's doing.
Exactly.
Did you get a chance to do that?
Yes. Yeah, I got an opportunity to go to school early just so I can understand the landscape.
Did you do it reluctantly? Did you like, I don't really want to go, but they're saying I should go?
No, it was time.
It was time.
You know what I'm saying? It was time for me to go to school because, you know, you're looking at accepting the challenge again, all over again.
Right.
And not just from the basketball aspect, but being the culture shock.
Right. Yeah.
Say, going to school.
And getting away.
You know what I'm saying?
And
getting away and learning how to be on your own. And more than anything, the most important part about what we talk about is time management. Learning how to manage time.
Nobody's telling you to go to class.
Nobody's telling you to go to class. Nobody's checking on your class. You ain't nobody coming. You know, you got to get up and do this.
Right.
Pretty much.
And they all give you pats on the back because you play on the squad and all that kind of stuff.
You get that. But if you mess up in school, you gonna get that knock.
Yeah, that will happen. Don't want that. Can you look into the camera and give Tyler a message that he can look back on and take with him after today's day?
All I can say, man, you know, again, knowing you since we were a kid as well, since you were a kid in diapers, man, just to see your journey and the young man that you turned out to be. But sky's the limit for you. You know, life is full of ups and downs, you know, peaks and valleys.
Uh-huh.
What determines us to be the men that we are is how we adjust and deal.
Adjusting everything that's happening.
Exactly.
That's good.
So I look forward to it, man. Love it.
That's going to be real fun.
But he got to kick ass and take names from day one. And that's what I explained to him. Nobody knows who you are.
Uh-huh.
So they're going to challenge you
right
when you get to college because they know you're coming in here with a purpose to try to.
And then he's coming in with an entourage that includes, you know, the NBA legends and being known and all that.
And that bullseye's on your back, though.
You think he's up for it?
He got to be. If he's not up for it, he's going to be back home with us.
Yeah, can't and that ain't going to work.
Can't bring your ass here.
Yeah, ain't gonna be here. Ain't gonna be in the gym. But you've done a good job. Well, is that what your uncle said years ago when you had to get that call back?
I already knew what it meant.
You already knew.
What I'm saying? I'm venting to my aunt. Hey, I don't know if
they don't want
to
hear that.
The right decision. Pass me that phone, Mary.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, you want to deal with Coach Boeheim or you want to deal with me?
That's all you needed.
That's all I needed to hear.
And you were straight.
I want to come back home.
The rest was history.
History.
He did that.
Yes.
Derrick, we're going to keep checking in with you. We know your summer's getting ready to jump off the DC League Summer League over at Birmingham Groves.
Start off Big Monday at Groves.
Yeah, and you taking on a new role with AAU here in the area.
It's just so much that's going on in AAU that I disagree with because I just feel that the parents have so much lack of information out there.
Sure.
You got all these guys running around here talking about their AAU. Are not the clubs are not registered. Their kids are not registered.
Uh-huh.
But you're lying to these parents, charging them,
giving them money,
astronomical money.
Sure.
Hosting these events that are not even insured.
Wow.
At all. So it's all the money grab.
Uh-huh.
You know, with you guys. I was on the phone the other day. We were on a Zoom call. It was 21 of us on that call.
Uh-huh.
Myself, Carmelo Anthony, Houston, Junkyard Dog.
All right, JYD.
Richardson, you had a bunch of
all of you guys want to get engaged.
All of us are getting engaged with AAU.
Oh, wow.
We have a meeting in July at the NBA Summer League to talk about AAU and the way that it's going that none of us might, because nobody's teaching anymore the sport the way it's supposed to be taught. The biggest thing is, Lindsay, is that in the last 6 years, all the MVPs in the NBA have been foreigners.
Wow.
The last 6 years. Think about that.
Yeah. Now you're absolutely right. And that means that there's more work that needs to be done on
the whole front. What are they doing that we're doing? Because they still have a skill set.
Yeah.
They're still learning how to play the game the right way, fundamental basketball.
And that's taking
we've
far.
Gotten so far away from that. How can you say that you're an AAU coach, right?
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. And going to play 5 and 6 games.
There's no opportunity for development.
There's no opportunity for development. There's no opportunity for camaraderie with the kids, no chemistry, no anything.
And then we got to compete.
And you got to compete.
We're going to make sure we follow up on that. We won't touch this issue, but high school NIL is making its way. That's another thing, and we'll make our way around to that.
Well, I think, you know what, with the high school NIL situation is with parents, again, have to understand not going to get NIL.
Right.
And I think that's the problem, that parents don't get it and understand about the game, not just basketball, but all sports.
Uh-huh.
You got to be an exceptional athlete to actually get NIL money.
So we need to manage these expectations.
You got to manage the expectations, but also you have to manage the people.
Right.
So when you talk about financial literacy and everything, with any type of money or situation that you are getting, because you have to pay taxes on it.
And that's
what
we
think that there's still lack of information in what we're talking about, even with our parents and everybody else.
Yeah. Well, we're looking forward to watching you and what you're doing as always. Continue to elevate Ty and all these other young people. And I just want to say I appreciate you. And it's been another good one.
Man, it's going to always be good, man. You know what I'm saying? We just have to keep working and grinding at it.
I know you won't stop.
But no, I tell people this all the time, right? We're the blueprint, Lance.
Mm-hmm.
So what are we doing? We the generation now.
Right.
So who's the
don't have to ask somebody for no permission or no opportunities. Like, they're looking at us to do it, so you got
to do it.
I'm motivated.
Who's going to do it? But doing it the right way.
Right. And we see young men like Tyler as the ones who benefit from that.
Yeah, he's an exception from that because, like I said, he's at a great foundation.
Right.
And what he's doing.
Right.
So how do we expand that foundation with all the other kids that you see here today?
We're going to make sure we do that.
Yeah, no doubt.
With that being said, we have the legend, Big Lefty, 1990 number one draft pick, Shaquille O'Neal. Said, yeah, one guy who dunked on me, Derrick Coleman, but still doing great things, and I'm great to have him as a friend, and he's a friend to everyone else, too, no doubt. All right, guys, we'll see you next time. Peace.
Appreciate you. All right.